My lab is interested in the host immunity to the pulmonary infectious disease tuberculosis. I'm here today to discuss the results of a finding that will appear in a paper in the Journal of Clinical Investigation. Tuberculosis is a global health problem with one-third of the world's population infected with Mycobacterium tuberculosis, the organism that causes TB. The geographical areas where TB is endemic overlaps with geographical areas where helminth worms are prevalent. 1 billion people are infected with one or more helminths, of which 207 million people at least are infected with Schistosoma mansoni. Helminth co-infections are believed to contribute to increased susceptibility to tuberculosis. However, the mechanisms by which helminth infections drive increased susceptibility to tuberculosis are not fully understood. We and others have shown that recruitment of T helper cell type 1 cells to the lung to activate lung macrophages is required for protective immunity against tuberculosis. In the current study, we addressed how helminth co-infections modulate immunity against tuberculosis. To address how helminth infections modulate immunity to tuberculosis, we first infected mice with Schistosoma mansoni followed by infection with Mycobacterium tuberculosis. We observed that mice that were co-infected with both tuberculosis and Schistosoma showed increased disease severity as reflected by the inflammatory area that we measured in the lungs of co-infected mice. We also observed that the increased inflammation coincided with accumulation of arginase-positive macrophages in the lung. These arginase-positive macrophages were present in the form of type 2 granulomas and were distinct from the type 1 granulomas induced by Mycobacterium tuberculosis infection. Not only were these results observed in mice co-infected with tuberculosis, but when we measured the arginase activity in sera of human active tuberculosis patients who were co-infected with helminths, we found increased arginase activity when compared to sera from active TB patients. Since we found increased expression of arginase-positive macrophages in the co-infected mice, we then addressed if depletion of arginase 1 in macrophages would specifically reverse disease severity in co-infected mice. Thus, we generated mice that were deficient in arginase expression in the lung macrophages and found that this not only resulted in decreased accumulation of arginase-positive macrophages in the lung, but this also reversed disease severity in co-infected mice. We then addressed if we can reverse increased disease susceptibility in co-infected hosts by treatment with anti-helminthics. We found that treatment of co-infected mice with praziquantel reversed increased disease susceptibility, and this was because we decreased arginase 1 accumulating macrophages in the lung and also decreased increased susceptibility to tuberculosis. We found that we could recapitulate increased susceptibility to tuberculosis simply by immunization of MTB-infected mice with Schistosoma egg antigen, an immunomodulatory product of the parasite. Based on our results, we proposed that helminth and helminth products drive induction of arginase 1 expressing macrophages, which then form inflammatory granulomas, increasing disease severity upon MTB infection. Not only did we find increased arginase 1 activity in co-infected hosts, but we also found that active tuberculosis patients showed increased arginase 1 mRNA expression, and arginase 1 activity correlates with increased disease severity in active TB patients. Based on our results, we propose that arginase 1 has a prominent role to play in inflammation and disease severity during tuberculosis. We have identified that helminth and its products can drive arginase 1 expression in pulmonary macrophages, thereby increasing disease severity to MTB infection. We also show that anti-helminth treatment and absence of arginase 1 expression in macrophages can reverse increased disease severity to the MTB infection. Thus, we've described a new mechanism by which helminth co-infections increase susceptibility to tuberculosis.